Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here. You know, how do I do Bible study? I get asked this question from time to time. And I'll just tell you, I mean, what I do is I've gone through like my Bible reading plan that I read out of four different Bibles. Now, they're all the King James Version of the Bible, but what it is this is something that I've noticed in how doing Bible study, that sometimes if I read with either different size fonts or paragraphed like the originals would have been, most of the originals would, to our knowledge, not have had verse numbers. You know, there's some like Lamentations and Psalm 119 and stuff like that. But for the most part, you know, most of them did not. I mean, there's some others that did, but so in a paragraph form, I tend to get things that I don't get otherwise. And over the course of my life, I went through a time for years, I read out of a chronological Bible, the Reese Chronological Bible, and got a lot of neat stuff out of that. And then I had a Bible by Barry Mosher that was paragraphed that I read out of. So what I do now is I read my Cambridge large print, and then I read a local church Bible publishing edition of it in just slightly smaller print. So I'm getting it from two different things, because I mean, you can just get to where you almost skim over stuff even if you don't mean to. And then I'll read out of my Cambridge paragraph Bible, and I've just started reading out of, in the last few months, the Schuyler Canterbury as well, and I read three different places there. So of course, you know, you want to prepare your heart to seek the Lord. You want, since it's a holy book and the Holy Spirit teaches us out of His holy scriptures, you want to make sure you have clean hands, pure heart, prayed up. And so then I just begin to read out of the scripture. And as I get the various things that, as I've read the Bible through, you know, I don't know how many times, several dozens of times, I figured it up years ago, it was quite a bit, and done some since then. Now I read the Bible, the Old Testament through like every 6 months, and then the New Testament, I read it three times in 6 months. Now, I know all scripture's equally inspired. That's just where I'm at now, because I went through a season of my life, for some reason, it seemed like when I was just reading the Bible straight through, that I was too far from reading the New Testament sometimes. Like, I could tell by the time I got to, you know, Jeremiah and stuff, it's been a long while since I'd read the New Testament. So that's where I'm at. So when I get to a place, I'll just say, like Psalm 65 and 1, praise waiteth for thee, O God, in Zion, and unto thee shall the vow be performed. Well, then, if I've got my little iPad with me, I will go to Blue Letter Bible. And let's say there's something about vowels that I want to look up. Well, Blue Letter Bible allows me to go, you know, I'll do V-O-W and then an asterisk, and that'll let me get vowel or vowels, you know, any combination. And then you just hit a button, show Strong's words, and it'll let you do a word study from Strong's and many cases from Vines. And it's totally free. I'm very thankful for the Blue Letter Bible. That's the one I use. I have tons of friends that use like Bible Hub or eSword, and some get into their own proprietary software. I'm more into the free software realm. I used to be a Bible software salesman, and so I knew a lot about WordSoft and BibleSoft and PC Study Bible and Logos and some of the other one, BibleWorks, and there's another one who I can't think of now that a lot of people just love. But I can do pretty much everything I want to do from that. And so then, like if I'm on a particular subject, like I'll just show you in the front of my Bible, this is my large print. So no matter which of the four Bibles I'm reading from, I can come back here and I've got various subjects. Like I'll put an I in front of for inspiration. I've got in the back, I've got some things of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, where Jesus said He'd raise His body from the dead, the Holy Spirit raises His body from the dead, the Father raises His body from the dead, and that type thing. And I'll show you a system in here also that I've got for verses as well. So this is what a Bible page looks like. So like you can see on Genesis 1:1, whenever I'm running across passages on creation, I'm just putting them where I can read them. And I also preach out of this Bible. It really helps me to read and preach out of the same Bible, because you kind of know where things are at. And then I'll just show you some systems I have that you might can see. Yeah, there's some things in here, like UES is my system for unconditional eternal security. That scripture has something to do with the subject of unconditional eternal security. I is inspiration. O is the oneness of God or the deity of Jesus Christ. CR is for creation or creator. H is for holiness. HE is for healing. And so these are all little devices that I have. So then let's say I'm going to write a pamphlet or something. I can just go through each page of my Bible and I immediately know where there's something on that particular subject. NB stands for new birth. You know, I just try to say, what is God trying to communicate here? What was God and the original author? What were their purposes? You know, you don't want to rest scripture. You want it to just to be, and you want it to fit in with the rest of scripture. The Bible says, and study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. 2 Timothy 2:15. So rightly dividing the word of truth, that there is an Old Testament, a New Testament. That's a natural division. There is the kingdom age, so to speak, where the kingdom of God suffereth violence. Take it by force. In the John the Baptist, Jesus age. And then there's when the Holy Spirit is given. The Holy Spirit is given on the day of Pentecost. And John 7:37-39 talks about that. And this is the church age. And so you're going to see how the early church acted in the book of Acts, obviously. And then you're going to go through the letters that the early church, the apostles, wrote to the early church in the epistles. So you're going to have hints of salvation, how to be saved in the epistles, but you're going to find out how to be saved in the book of Acts, and then they got it from Jesus, and so this is where you get the Great Commission scriptures and the Gospels. And this is the reason I'm totally convinced that what God was trying to communicate to Jew and Gentile alike, that Acts 2:38 is the plan of salvation in this day and age, and that there was no cessation of gifts, that the Holy Spirit, speaking of tongues, is still the sign or the initial evidence of receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and that the name of Jesus is to be called over a person at baptism, and it is for the remission of sins. So this is how I do Bible study, because if you don't, like, I've noticed a huge thing is people are celebrating Passover, celebrating Pentecost, and not just kind of saying it's kind of cool, let me show you how it was done, or let's see how they did it, but they're like saying you have to do this to be saved, or Old Testament dietary laws. Well, then you're not rightly dividing the word of truth. At the same time, people like say in 1 Corinthians 6, all things are lawful unto me. They're like, I can basically do anything I want as long as I name the name of Jesus. No, that's in a specific context, because there's over 1,000 New Testament commands to be holy, and obviously there's certain things that are sinful and wrong. Even in the previous chapter, in that chapter, 1 Corinthians 6, he just went through all these people, revilers, drunkards, and all these people are not going to make heaven. And so he says that. And so there's tons of things that we're not supposed to do as Christians, and tons of things we are supposed to do. True religion and undefiled before God the Father is this, to visit the fatherless and the widows in their affliction, keep oneself unspotted from the world. So rightly dividing the word of truth. That's how I do my Bible study. And You know, I don't want to just take scriptures in isolation. I've gone through like the K. Arthur. I actually sat on a plane next to K. Arthur one time, and then she was checking into a hotel I was a desk clerk at, so kept running into. But, and I appreciate her wanting to know scripture, but at the same time, sometimes that's not the best way to do scripture. So that's how I do my Bible study. I always recommend to people prayerfully just read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. Start over again, go from Matthew to Revelation, and you start getting a feel for what's in Scripture at that time. And the overarching theme of Scripture is Jesus Christ. And there's layers to Scripture, and you begin to see massive paradigms that God has, that the more you read it, it's like it's never ending. It's like a coal mine, strip mining for coal. It just goes layer, and it's like, wow, this is incredible. That's where I learn things every day from the Bible. I didn't know. So God bless. Talk with you later. Study that Bible. The Bible tells us to. Amen. God bless.